Hello, girls and guys. My name is Darko, and you must subscribe this channel. Thank you.
Jei atvirai, tai aš neįsivaizduoju, kada buvau turėjęs tokį karštį. Ant tiek karšta. Šiandien, jei neklystu, ant pavėsio 39. Ant pavėsio. Tai ant saulutės bus toksai link kokių kem 7 žiauro. Pavažiavau ant navigacijos per telefoną, kadangi buvo ant magneto. 4 minutės ir telefonas užsidegė emergency heat ir panašiai ir žodžiu showdownino. Kas turi iPhone'us žino, kad nuo karščio jisai sustoja veikti ir laukia tada, kada jisai atvės. 4 minutės automobilyje. Plasmasės net visokios gumos pradėjo, ne tai kad lydytis, bet mūsų visokie lipdukai pradėjo atšokinėti ir panašiai. Žiauru, dar tai bus 3 dienas, jo, 3 dienas. Ir dabar man reikia nueiti iki vieno taško. Ir negaliu, neatsimu vietos, o telefonas dar užkaitęs, įdėjau telefoną į kuprinę, nu ten bent pavėsis, tai atvės kokiais 5-7 laipsniais gal atsigaus. Ai, nu so. Be žodžių, dabar ne apie tai.
Atsisėsim čia naės po pušelė, po eglę.
Prieš 2 metus, spalio mėnesį, keliavau Skandinavijos kelionė, tai buvo 2019 metų, spalio mėnesis, taip, jau temperatūra po truputį krito, aš važiavau link Hamburgo, išstikau vyruką vardu Askina, kuris planavo keliauti į Nordkapą, neplanavo, tą ir darė. Kiekvieną dieną mindamas po 200 km nuo Bavarijos, nuo savo namų, iki pat Nordkapo, iki pat šiauriausio Europos taško. Ir mes tada susipažinom, apsikeitėm kontaktus ir iki pat dabar palaikom ryšį. Tuo metu jam nepasisekė ta kelionė. Ir jisai man dabar parašė prieš keletą dienų, sako sveikas. Aš mačiau, kad jisai keliauja, pradeda keliauti nuo Bavarijos iki Balkanų ir turbūt atgal. Ir susirašėm, kokie jo planai, kokie mano planai. Ir šią minutę jisai yra Podgoricoj. Tai keliavom susitikti su Askanu, po 2 metų pertraukos bus super awesome, ta prasme jisai prikaupė daug istorijų ir tikiuosi pateiks jisai ir jums tų istorijų, tai einam susitikti su Askanu.
Hi man, sorry I'm late, I was texting you.
Yeah,
did you get
the
message?
I got the message, but I have a SIM card, so but I found some free Wi-Fi around here.
Perfect, so nice. You have any recommendations where I can sit? It's fucking hot.
Yeah, there are some cafes over there, or we go to the park. There's a it's hill, it's like 10 minutes from here.
Okay, how are you?
I'm fine.
How's the bike?
Pretty nice.
So, this is all your equipment? Or you have more in the hostel?
Yeah, I have in the hostel, I have more. It's like this. It's like this, and I have for the race, I'm going to have 2 bottles here. So,
perfect.
Works nice, yeah.
Damn, I miss it.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Yes. So, what do you prefer?
Where is colder?
I think up there.
Alright.
Taigi, mes su Askanu susitikom like 2 years ago, we met, something like that. I was on the road to Hamburg, keliavau pro link Hamburgo iki Tautvilo, and Askan was traveling to the North Cape. Yeah. And after, I remember that like after 10 or 11 days, you fucked up with your leg.
Yes.
What happened?
Because it was inflamed and I overdone it totally.
Because it was like traveling also.
I wasn't prepared that well for the trip. And
In a physical way?
In a physical way. Equipment was perfect. And I actually wanted to make 180 a day, I think, and then I figured out, wow, I can go 200, I can go 210 and 220, and
yeah, because
more and more and more.
When I check your stories,
you post the picture of the trip and of the road, and it was like 10 days, 2,000 kilometers.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
I thought, what the fuck? He's insane.
Yeah.
And like next day, bam.
Yeah, and then game over. Because I couldn't get pressure on the upper leg anymore. It was just like, it was no chance.
So,
and so I had to push the last 30 kilometers to the next city. Yeah.
After that, you just need rest, or you have damaged something more else?
No, I don't.
Just rest.
Actually don't know what it was. I was in the hospital, but they just checked it like, let's see, okay, it doesn't look too bad, but you shouldn't continue.
Yeah.
And
you come back to Germany by the bus?
Yeah, by bus and by truck driver.
Yeah. Tai žodžiu, kaip prieš du metus mes susitikome, įsikeliavo, kas šiandien nesuprato angliškai.
There's some auditory who don't understand English,
yes,
so I will explain for them.
Įsikeliavo į Nordkapą ir po 10 dienų, kiekvieną dieną minant po 200 km, jam tiesiog jau uždegė koją, galima taip pasakyti, uždegimas buvo raumens ir visiškai nebegalėjo minti, buvo dideli skausmai, po 10 dienų keliavimo, po 2000 km jisai sustojo ir nebegalėjo tęsti savo kelionės ir tada autobusu grįžo į Vokietiją, Bavariją. And the second try was in the winter, right?
Was the same at the same date
Yeah,
after.
So it was like 3 months ago, right? Maybe more. I was in Chile.
Where it was on the, I started on the 12th of October last year, and with two friends, and I had a very specific plan about it, and we wanted to make an average of 215 kilometers a day. And not only average, every day 215 kilometers, not like doing 180 and then you get
strict
kilometers back on the next day. That's
just strict 215 kilometers every day.
Yeah, exactly. And
but the trick is,
tada kai jis jau dabar va, prieš kelis mėnesius žiemą keliavo, ne prieš kelis mėnesius, jau prieš pusę metų keliavo į Norvegiją, į Nordkapą, jis keliavo su dviem draugiam.
You traveled with two girls, with a girl.
Oh, and the boy?
Yeah.
So two boys?
He dropped out. The point was we failed with our kilometer goal at the third day because we had a food poisoning in the middle of Germany.
Yeah.
And we had a break at a bus stop and all three of us had to throw up. And luckily there was a kind of hostel next to it, 100 meters away from it. And we could enter that and we stood there for 4 or 5 days till we had recovered, and then we continued. And the Julian, the third one, he dropped out in Hamburg after 4 days of cycling.
Tai va, keliavo dviese, du vyrukai ir viena mergina. Vyrukas atkrito po apsinuodijimo maistu ir beveik jisai su mergina pasiekė Nordkapą, bet mergina irgi atsisakė. Ir galiausiai...
What day did you reach the North Cape? What was the day?
28th of November, I think.
Whoa.
Because I actually...
What was the temperature?
Not so cold. It was... I think it was around zero.
Around zero. And
around
wind?
Again?
And the wind, how many meters per second? Okay, what was the strongest wind in the trip?
The strongest was maybe... the strongest was 65 kilometers.
65 kilometers per hour, so it's like, how many seconds? It's a lot.
It's a lot, yeah. It's a lot, you have to push because the surface of the road is so slippery that I couldn't get my handlebar straight, you know.
You're just going on the side.
Yeah, as soon as you can't hold your line, everything slips away.
And yeah.
It happened several times. And I crashed my shoulder one time. I couldn't lift my arm for 2 weeks. And
whoa.
It's still something...
broken?
Not broken, it's
some...
this strings. One is...
Yeah, not good.
Broken.
And right now,
You
feel it?
Yeah, sometimes when I lay down and when I lay on my right side. I think,
yeah.
But it's still okay.
You can live with that.
Yeah, yeah. It's okay. Yeah.
And in total, how many days from beginning to the end? With seven. All that stuff that you stuck on the border with Finland and Norway.
You don't think so, or? Ah!
74 days.
74 days.
74 days, including food poisoning, including fall over of Annika. She broke a pedal, and we had to get spare parts, which took us 2 days.
So it's like a little more than 2 months.
Yeah, including the Finnish border, because they didn't want to let us enter, and we wanted to build a raft to enter Finland on the river. Which
Yeah, I saw in the movie.
It didn't happen.
And this time, it's not included in that back time.
Yeah, it is included.
It's included. Yeah. You're back 4,000 kilometers in 20 days, right?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
So, taigi, Askinas sukūrė apie visą šitą savo kelionę iš Bavarijos į Nordkapą YouTube'į. Yra dokumentinis filmas, beveik 1 valandos laiko, tai įdėsiu video aprašymę. Pasižiūrėkit, tikrai insane, ta prasme, machine.
I understand insane and machine.
Ta prasme, geras dokumentinis filmas su visa istorija, background ir panašiai. Tai linkiu pasižiūrėti, o...
And this first. Trip, and this trip that you're not right now traveling, what was the idea?
I was in Montenegro 8 years ago, uh-huh. 2013, and I liked it a lot, so I wanted to get away from Germany and just
from
somewhere else.
From strict rules?
Yeah, from very strict rules, bullshit, and I wanted to get somewhere nice, and I came to Montenegro, and it is as nice as I remembered it.
Yeah. So from your home to Montenegro is 1,000?
1,200 around.
1,200?
Yeah.
In how many days?
I think in 7 days, but I'm not sure.
7 days.
I didn't count that one. It's a small trip.
And next, from here?
From here, back to Germany, only for a week. To change some parts on my bike, and then I'm going to Lake Garda in Italy, and from there starts the North Cape 4000, which is an ultra distance bicycle race, and it goes all the way up to the North Cape, and it leads through Austria, Slovenia, Croatia, Hungary, Poland, Lithuania,
Latvia, Estonia, Finland. Yeah,
and
yeah.
Then up.
All right. Cheers.
Cheerio.
For new trips.
Yeah. Clip pedals, because you don't get waterproof shoes. It's always at the clips, it's never waterproof. And so it's much...
Even if you're putting that extra layer on the top of the foot of the shoes...
Shoes. These things are never waterproof. You had something like this, I remember.
Yeah, I had
it. Was it waterproof? It was not, right?
Not for full time.
Yeah, exactly. And on my North Cape journey, I had waterproof shoes for flat pedals. And I had on the lash, there is always the weak spot. And I had on my rain trousers, I cut out of my old rain trousers, I cut out a piece and I attached it with glue to the end of my trousers, and I put like this, I don't know how it's called in English, like this, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Something like this, and I put
Velcro,
it,
Velcro.
I glued it on my shoes and on the end of this lash, and I put it over it, so mm-hmm. no water could drop in, and it was totally waterproof for days, and it was raining for days. And that worked out well,
mm-hmm.
that worked out very well. And rain clothing, so this is very important.
Yeah,
this is the most important part of your equipment.
I had,
on the trip.
I have good rain clothes, except shoes.
Yeah, yeah, shoes and the jacket. It always needs, you know,
with a hook.
Kapuze. Don't know the
with
English.
A hook.
Yeah, hood. Yeah. Hood. Exactly. Yeah.
And how we made the phone? Oh, it's magnets. Two magnets?
Actually, this is these magnets and this plate, it's from a car mount, magnetic mount for, uh-huh. for a car. And
it's good.
We cut out this piece from plexiglass.
Uh-huh.
And yeah.
Perfect.
Alrighty.
I will give you the camera.
You wanna wear a helmet?
Yeah.
Okay.
Traditional.
Uncomfortable, and I need to stop the bike. It's less space to. Maybe my fingers are too short. I'm more prepared with just straight bike. But yeah, nice bike. And light. Finally.
How is the camera?
The camera is nice. The lens is very good.
Yeah, it's 1680.
Yeah.
So we can zoom.
And it's well.
Yeah, extra water. It's inside should be really hot.
Or is it just?
Oh.
Ah, nice. A long time ago that I sat in a car.
Yeah, it's nothing special, but still.
Oh, it is something special. I think I never sat in that kind of car.
Yeah? Better on the bike, right? No, it's thick. Yeah, it's for our time. Yeah, simple car. With simple engine. No big deal.
Do you have to fix something on the way down?
Yeah,
several times.
But I guess this is the idea. What is the point to travel with a brand new car? I guess it's much more interesting with the old one.
Yeah. Do you know about cars?
No, not so much. My friends a little bit knows more. So this is maybe the idea that I'm traveling with the friends. All right. So how many kilometers still left for you to come back in Germany? Like, in total from here, like 2,000?
So including the tours I'm making here?
Yeah. 2.5, maybe 3.
Yeah, 3, I hope 3. I always have a hard time about training because I shouldn't overdo it, you know? It's also about the brakes I burnt.
Well, it's nice to meet you.
It was a pleasure, man.
Yeah, maybe somewhere on North Pole or maybe in here, Balkans, because we are also going some by the ocean, by the coast.
Yeah, you should go to Couture.
We plan to go to Couture, but I don't know, tomorrow or day after tomorrow, so we will see.
Yeah.
Keep in touch. Yeah. Next trip for me also will be on the bike, for sure. Ну ка, бегу влагали монтуати. Su Askinu įsiskyrėm, keliaus jisai toliau, o aš grįžau namo, reikėjo vlogą sumontuoti, tai sėdau montuoto hebrytį išvalį miesto centrą, tai taip įsiskyrėm, nu bet ką darysi, gal daug kažko labai nepraleisiu. Man buvo svarbiau su Askinu susitikti, pašnekėti, pabendrauti, žiūrėjau smagu, po 2 metų pertraukos, tai va vėl kažkur atsitiktinai. Juodkalnyjoj, Podgoricoje susitikti su bičiuliu žiūri fainai. Nu ką, tikėkime, jiems viskas bus ok. Ruošiasi North Cape 4000. Tai daugiau negu 4000 nuo šiaurės Italijos iki šiauriausio Europos taško North Cape'o. Ir sako, jis nori būti pirmas. O pirmas tai ką reiškia, kad jisai kiekvieną dieną planuoja nuvažiuoti po 350, po 400 km.
Tai sakau, jeigu tu po 400 kilų į dieną viniosi, tai realu, kad tu gali tą padaryti. Vien turint omeny, kad jisai su bagažu, jisai sugeba nuvažiuoti 250 km su turistiniu bagažu, tai ką kalbėti, kai dviratis lengvutis su labai labai mažai daiktų, tai manau, Askinas gali pavaryti pirmą vietą North Cape 4000, jeigu jisai po 400 km į dieną vynios, tai to jam ir palinkėsiu mušt rekordus, nes šiaip tais kai jau susitikom, pašnekėjom, tai toksai grinai, man atrodo, sielo žmogus apie visokias keliones, Amerikas, Azijas, Rusijas, kalnus, šiaurės, pietų polius, žodžiu, kur tik visokių keusių kelionių, idėjų, tai va, mintis konvertavosi tarpusavį, tai labai labai toksai žmogus, kur gali savo idėjas išpasakoti ir jisai jas pilnai supranta, jisai savo išpasakoja, kas atrodo kosmiškai, bet aš irgi visiškai suprantu, tai toksai visiškai nurautas žmogus. Tai kaip ir minėjau, pridėjęs jo dokumentinį filmą iki North Cape'o, kaip jisai keliavo. Ir, ai, ką dar čia norėjau pasakyti, kad jo, čia buvau, šiandien pasidalinau, bet turėjau realiai vakar su jumis pasidalinti per savo YouTube'ą, bet pamiršau. Tai turbūt, jo, dar šiandien ir rytoj, iki birželio 25 dienos yra nuolaida Europowderiams 30% su nuolaidos kodo Aurimas 30. Jo, nes mano papildėliai visi. Čia mano pakas. Vitaminų C, good. Jo, visai produkcijai 30%, tai turėkite mintyvą, gal kažkam reikia kažkokių vitaminų ar papildų, tai bus iki 25 dienos nuolaida, tai pridėsiu irgi linką, kad nepamirštumėt. Tai va, dabar čia mes esam šalia Podgoricos, netoli, 6 minutės iki miesto centro, o rytoj turime šiaip nemažai taškų, čia mes link Kotoro, jo. Tai iki Kotoro turim 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 taškai, čia vieni greičiau pravažiuojami, kiti lėčiau, miesteliai, apžvalgos aikštelės ir panašiai. Bet norime patirinėti daugiau Kotoro, nes toksai vienas iš svarbių miestų, kuriuos būtina aplankyti Juodkalnijoje, bet turime ir šalia pasižymėjau tokią gražią vietovę, kuri yra privažiuojama, yra keliukas prie pat Adrijos jūros ant kranto. Čia yra Adrijos jūra, siauroka, apie 1000 km, jeigu taip žiūrint, bet siauroka. Tai būtų fainai pernakvoti ten, o tam tarp yra aplankyti šitas vietas, tai matysim, kaip čia seksis mums. O paskui, po truputį, aš įsivaizduoju, palei šitą pakrantį judėsim link Albanijos. Būtų fainai aplankyti sostinę, tada iššokti į Kosovo ir tada į Šiaurės Makedoniją. Ir tada iš tiesų šokam, grįžtam į savo kelią ir važiuojam prieš laikrodžio rodiklę Makedonija, Bulgarija, Rumunija, Juodoji jūra ir tada atgal į Belgradą. Tai dabar rytoj kol kas žinom, kad važiuojam šitu keliu, o kur nakvosim, matysim turbūt vietoj. Reikia įgult, nes ir to norisi anksčiau išvažiuoti, aišku, temperatūra bus ta pati, 39 ant pavėsio, saulės net neįsivaizduoju kiek. Ir žodžiu, kepiklėlė toliau tęsiasi, nu bet neturim kitų opcijų. Nebus taip, kad vieną dieną išlauksim ir praeis, nes čia panašu, kad iki savaitgalio dar kepins. Tai, žodžiu, teks prisitaikyti ir daugiau kremo teptis. Tai tiek šiandien. O Askanas rytoj irgi pajuda. Tai gal dar susitiksim su juo kažkur kelyje, bus matyti. Tva, greit. Čiau.